never opened her channel. I'm like, you need to do it.
Mm-hmm.
She got about like 300,000 followers on Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
But doesn't have a YouTube channel.
Yeah, she should definitely do it. You can make some decent money. I haven't made a lot of money because basically the videos that people were watching, I was doing glute massage, and they really like that. And so I have three videos, one with 100,000, well, that's not true. So I have one video where I was doing a technique in front of some guy's hip, and they really liked that video. That was 100,000. Another with this one guy, I don't know why everyone likes his butt, but people on TikTok and YouTube like his butt a lot. So that got 120,000. And then I was working on a CrossFit athlete, and I was cupping his glutes, and that got 170,000 views. And combined, those are what got me my 4,000 hours. And since then, it's slowed down. Now some of my videos are getting like several hundred views. Some of them are getting several thousand views. So I haven't made that much, but you know, with those three videos, had I been monetized, I probably would have made like, you know, $500.
Well, that's good.
But it's fine. I actually mainly do this for Instagram. And then TikTok, and then YouTube less.
Like right now, I put like reels on my Instagram, mm-hmm. and I'm getting paid.
Are you?
Yeah.
Oh, they
said. It's really weird. I got a friend, and he got like now over 30,000 followers.
Oh, wow.
His videos are like 5,000 views, got like a lot of views, like way more than me, and he hasn't got like the invitation.
I see.
That's weird.
Yeah, it's very weird. One of my clients, he does meal prep.
Uh-huh.
He said he got the invitation, but he didn't post enough videos. So he ended up, because he said it was like you had to post a certain number of videos.
The first one, it was like, do three reels and you will get like $105.
Yeah.
Just three reels. I'm like, okay, I did it and I got the money, right?
Okay.
And then like a month after that, I got the invitation to monetize, and they said, like, I can do till.
Oh, okay, so they have the
1,200. And you have, like, a month to buy. You need to have, like, crazy views, like.
Yeah.
After the $100, they count, like, views, like, 50 cents, something like that. But then when you got 200, each view is going to count, like, 0.005.
Yeah.
So after 100, it's like, you see the money is not growing. Yeah. But still, like, you post whatever and... So I had the invitation, and last month I got like $150. And,
oh, okay.
And then I got another invitation.
Mm-hmm.
That's the one I have right now, but I haven't posted.
I see.
Like, right now I got like $60 or something.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, still.
Yeah.
Gas money.
Exactly. Even if I don't make a lot on YouTube, because these videos are, I primarily do this for Instagram. So basically, I like massage someone, I record the massage, and then I like kind of cut up the part that I like the most. Like, oh, this looks really good. This is like a good representation of what I do. And then I make it into a post on Instagram. And so one, when people like are deciding if they want to come get a massage, they can see what I do, and they can say, oh, okay, I want to go get that. I've had a lot of clients actually tell me that I came in because I saw this particular video. But also, like, when I post, it kind of reminds people to come get a massage. Because people forget all the time. Yeah. People put off getting a massage for weeks, months, sometimes years. also put them on TikTok because I get a lot more views from TikTok than Instagram.
You could make money too there.
Mm-hmm. And then I put them on YouTube because I was like, oh, why not? You know, maybe somebody will see the videos on YouTube and come in.
Yeah. Have you find a way to like add like ads? That's when you can start making like more money.
Like on TikTok or YouTube?
On YouTube.
Oh yeah, I have that now. So I'm like, it's monetized. So now when someone runs an ad or watches an ad, I get like a tenth of a penny or something. Yeah. It's very little money. But, you know, if you have, 20,000, 50,000, 100,000 views, it starts to add up.
Yeah, I got a friend, he did a video for it, the movie, like the clown, the makeup. Mm-hmm. And his video went, like, viral, like, 50 million views or something like that. And he got, like really good money for that.
Yeah.
Just for that video.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there are people who are, they make millions just off of the views they get on YouTube. A lot of people, they will, they do like unboxing, so they'll buy a new phone, and they'll just take the phone out of the box and like talk about the box and the phone and everything. And there are people who can make millions of dollars doing that. But my main goal is to show people that I know what I'm doing, so that they come in and get a massage.
Do you see I'm all fucked up there?
Oh, you're pretty good.
It's like all connected, like the shoulder and the back and the...
Mm-hmm. I've seen worse, trust me. Oh, so what kind of dancing do you do? Because I haven't worked on as many dances as I would like to.
Well, I used to dance.
Gotcha.
With this singer that I told you, and then I was in another group with, do you know Josebi Quintanilla?
Mm-hmm.
Salinas' brother?
Okay.
Well, he got a group called Cumbia Kings.
Mm-hmm.
I was there too, dancing.
Gotcha.
But now I'm a promoter. I produce events, parties, I bring DJs. And
mm-hmm.
Like, I'm still in the industry, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Different area.
A lot of people don't realize that dancing is athletically very intense.
Yeah, it is. Like, with this singer,
mm-hmm.
I used to dance like 4-5 songs max
mm-hmm.
in a show like an hour and a half, right?
Yeah.
Like, that's nothing. And with the group, with the Cumbia Kings, oh my God, it was like all show.
Mm-hmm.
That was killing. Like, you have no idea.
Mm-hmm.
Some shows I had to take like pre-workout, like
mm-hmm.
Refill like pills to like the energy,
mm-hmm.
Red Bull. It's crazy. for Florida?
Yes, yeah, for a long ago.
You're by yourself here?
Yes.
No family at all?
No, most of my family is in Florida. I have some family in Georgia. I do miss Florida.
I lived for a little in Orlando.
Orlando?
Yeah. But I was in the same situation as you, like no family.
Yeah.
Some friends, but not really. So it was hard.
Yeah. I do plan on going back. I would like to move to Tampa. It's just that Florida is much more expensive than Houston. So I would like to save up as much as possible.
And work-wise, and more work here, or?
It's just much more expensive. And so I want to save up. I don't want to go back down there and have to work for someone else.
Yeah.
So I want to make sure I have enough money saved up so I don't have to work for at least 18 months. And, you know, build up my business down there.
Yes, that's good.
Because it takes time to build a clientele. Especially when you work for yourself. It's really more just getting your name out there. People don't always know who you are. And then even when they know who you are, people forget very quickly. You kind of have to always remind people.
Yeah.
Everyone's very busy.
The thing is, like, I think in general, like, all of us, like, we don't take care of our body like the way it should be. You know what I mean? That's true. It is.
And that's the massage I do. I don't do massage for stress relief. I do massage for, you know, to enhance physical fitness. Do some cupping on this shoulder. How's that feel?
Good. Done cupping, but never like this. Like,
yes, there are a lot of different ways to do cupping. Some people do fire cupping. Some people use acrylic cups.
I have done this one, but it's just like in certain area. Not like moving like this, but it feels great.
I found this is much more beneficial.
And that's the only thing about cupping. It doesn't always work well with body hair. It kind of releases the seal. Tension on this side. How's that feel?
Good.
that feel?
Good.
To move that shoulder around and arm around and tell me how it feels.
Which one?
Yeah, that's one.
To move it how?
Just kind of move it around. Just tell me how you feel.
Better. Yeah. A little bit more loose.
So I didn't get too much of a chance to check out your page. Like, what kind of stuff do you post on Instagram?
Everything. For my work and my personal and the events.
Mm-hmm.
So we got a pretty good follow on the, mm-hmm. the events. So last year we did an event that we had like 1,200 people.
Mm-hmm. Like midtown, downtown, or like
downtown.
Okay.
Yeah. I will show you pictures.
Yeah. Because I know some people, when they say downtown, they mean midtown.
Yeah, no, I know what is midtown and downtown. I was used to be confused too.
Mm-hmm. And I feel like it's only been the last few years that there's been anything going on downtown.
Yeah.
It used to be it was a ghost town when I moved here. Like after people, you know, went home from work, there was nothing happening downtown.
Yeah. Like when COVID. So we got people from everywhere traveling.
Mm-hmm. Are you right-handed?
Yes.
tight.
That feel
great. You do the editions on YouTube, or you just put like the whole video, or?
So it depends on where I put it. On YouTube, I don't put the whole thing on YouTube. Yeah. Because there are parts that are kind of boring. Nobody wants to see me, you know, walking to the hot towel caddy and getting oil. But you know, I kind of put the most of it on YouTube. Uh-huh. Like, so some of my videos on YouTube are like 18 minutes long. Some are like 3 or 4 minutes long. On Instagram and TikTok, they're much shorter, so I don't...
Yeah.
The longest video I have on Instagram and TikTok is like 1 minute and like 3 seconds. People on Instagram and TikTok have much shorter attention spans.
Yeah, it's really easy because you just like swipe next video. And YouTube, it's different. You have to go back or you have to scroll.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And with Instagram, with the reels, it's like you just
switch. Yeah.
Up.
And Instagram, you know, will show you like the average like view length. Like Instagram does it. TikTok is better with like giving you information, and you can see like, oh, the average person watched 7 seconds of this video. Like, people don't watch you know. But then some people watch a lot of videos. Someone watched, I think somebody watched one of my videos for over an hour on TikTok. Wow. He said, I've watched this video like 200 times. I didn't believe him.
Yeah, I think it's probably because TikTok is more like people get there to see like people dancing or to jokes or like, it's a different crowd.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he said he watched it 200 times. I thought he was just saying that. But then I looked and I saw that he had liked my video at one point and then favorited it at another point, and it was an hour apart. So I'm like, oh, maybe he really did watch this, like, you know, over and over and over again. And also on YouTube, people skip around a lot. So if you have a longer video, they'll kind of skip around to the parts they like.
Yeah. And now it's telling you, like, what's the more, like, replay part.
Yeah, it does. So it'll, like, tell me, oh, you had a spike in traffic here. So it'll tell me, okay, so more people watched this one part in the middle than they did in the beginning. And originally, when I put my stuff on YouTube, I put it like just like the stuff from TikTok. But people started complaining that it was too short. So I realized people who watch TikTok videos want longer videos. Sorry, people who watch YouTube videos want longer videos. YouTube gives you a lot of information. My second video that did well on YouTube, a lot of people shared it in India and Indonesia on WhatsApp.
Oh wow. And WhatsApp?
Mm-hmm.
He told you to that?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So it'll tell me like where is my video being shared outside of YouTube. So it'll tell me, oh, are people like sharing it on Facebook.
That's crazy. WhatsApp. I didn't know.
Mm-hmm. It gives you a lot of information.
Wow.
So on YouTube, most of the people who watch are, most of my videos are older men in the United States, India, Indonesia, and Japan. Probably why my videos are mostly watched in the morning over here. It's probably like the afternoon or evening in like India.
Yeah, it depends. Like Europe is like 8 hours.
Yeah.
But then Asia is like different.
Yeah, I get more viewers between, I think it's 4 a.m. and 10 a.m. Instagram used to give you a lot more information, but they've gotten bad. Like now with my reels, I can't even tell like which of my followers have seen it. I used to be able to see that on Instagram.
Like for me that I'm like now monetizing, mm-hmm. It will tell you like you have like 45,000 viewers, they know like subscribe.
I see.
They will tell you.
But I still prefer Instagram because it's the easiest way for me to get my stuff in front of people in Houston specifically. And since, you know, I have a local
business.
Have
you, pay to get,
I run ads.
Yeah. I used to boost my... That's good. Because you can target.
Yeah. So I target between 5 and 10 miles of this location.
Yeah, you can even, choose, the ages of the people, sex.
If you go into Instagram, not Instagram, Meta has something called their ad manager.
Uh-huh.
It's a little annoying because in order to put ads up, you have to, it's the ads from Facebook.
Yeah.
So I have to add the video or picture to
if
Facebook.
If you do it on Facebook, it goes automatically on Instagram.
Yeah. So I have to, but I don't use Facebook a lot. I just don't use Facebook. I don't even have the app on my phone, so I have to go and upload it to Facebook. But then once you have it on Facebook, you can go into the ad manager, and you can take any of the Facebook posts and run an ad from them. And when you do that, you have a ton of options. So my ad right now runs to men and women within 7 miles of here who are into bodybuilding, powerlifting,
fitness.
I did some testing to see who likes my stuff most. Oh, and mixed martial arts. Yeah, and people who do mixed martial arts, they like my massage. And it's men and women over the age of 24 who are the top 5% income earners in the U.S.
Wow.
So, yeah, you get more options if you go into their Facebook ad manager. You can even say you only want to run an ad to people who have an iPhone with a certain version. It's crazy how you can target. But I just want to target people who
are because we run ads for our events, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, but I didn't know you can do all that. We choose basic.
Yeah, I followed this one guy on YouTube. His name is Ben Heath. And he has just a ton of videos on Facebook ads, and so I learned a lot about how to run a Facebook ad. And you can do all kinds of stuff. You can do testing to see. That's why I do mixed martial arts and not CrossFit, because when I did testing, I found that I got better results from people who were into mixed martial arts than CrossFit. So I know the type of activities that people are more likely to click the ad for. And it works. I've got a lot of customers that come in that way. I've also scared some customers.
What?
I've had some of them tell me they see my videos and they get intimidated.
Because the pain or...
Mm-hmm.
My mom is super shy and that,
mm-hmm.
So I was trying to take her to the other place that I told you, but I was last year.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, mom, you need a massage to relax. And
mm-hmm.
No, I can't. She didn't want to.
Yeah.
She's like, no, it's very old school.
Yeah.
And very nobody, she don't like people watching her, or
mm-hmm.
maybe getting changed or stuff like that. She's
yeah.
like, no.
Yeah, when I worked at a chain spa, there were a lot of people like that. I worked on one lady, she was an older lady from India, and her therapist told me that in India it would be improper for her to get a massage from a man. But her therapist was pregnant, so I had to work on her.
Oh, wow.
So I ended up working on her in a jean jacket. So she left all her clothes on. She just took her shoes off.
Wow.
And left her jacket on, and I gave her a massage. And her husband was even in the room, but she was still just uncomfortable.
Yeah, it's the belief of... everyone. Oh, fuck, it's different.
But she really liked the massage, though. And it's good. I've taken a table Thai class. And in my school, the first thing we did was chair massage. So I'm better than a lot of people in Houston at working on people with clothes on. Because I've been trained to work on people with clothes on a lot. Yeah, the cans can be pretty intense.
I think I never had a cough massage ever. Ever.
Especially if you do a lot of walking. I guess as you're a promoter, do you have to do a lot of walking around?
Not right now, but I used to be a dancer, and I used to be a Zumba teacher. So, I know anymore.
Did I see like any Zumba stuff on your Instagram, or was that somebody else?
Yeah, I think probably like all.
Okay.
Well, you probably saw was some recent video that the singer, she called me again, so I went to Mexico.
See. Oh, okay.
She's like, well, she used to be like huge, like after, you know, Selena, right? When Selena passed away, the 2 years after, she broke the record of her here at the Astrodome.
I see.
Yeah. Yeah. She said Mexican music with like accordion and that, and now she does like mariachi. Yeah, when she was younger, she was big, big, big. Yeah. Selena, I'm just saying that she was huge.
You know, I don't think I get a lot of people from Mexico viewing my stuff. It's really interesting how much information YouTube gives you. cupping on this calf.
Yeah, I'd be feeling kind of like a tendon, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
Like in the inside part of the back of the knee.
Mm-hmm.
Right? that they will.
Yeah, if you put like the VR headset on, it feels like you're in the room. Yeah, the claws can be a little sensitive. Oh, if someone's going to see you with your shirt off, you may want to warn them about the cuffing. Because I can see it a little bit right here.
No, I have done it before.
Okay.
So, yeah.
Well, with the cupping, I do.
I have done the cupping in my back. And they did a little bit on my shoulders. So I know what to expect. Gotcha. So, yeah.
Well, no, you said you didn't have it the way I do it.
No, so no, not like that.
You won't have circles?
It'll be, you know, you have the...
Yeah, it's gonna be big streaks.
Different. That's cool.
Yeah.
I will come back, dog, for you to work just my shoulder.
Yeah. So it looks like someone beat you up. But some people like that. Yeah. I've had people tell me they want to make sure they have the marks. And it's fine if you're hairy. I have one client, he uses 3 times as much lotion as everyone else.
Because he was super hairy?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I mean, I'm hairy, but not like
crazy.
Trust me, I have seen worse.
Mm-hmm.
Like worse. I'm pretty sure you do too.
Mm-hmm. I worked on people who look like Chewbacca.
I normally train like this part, mm-hmm. but I haven't. So. Like no shape, just train lower down. But I like my hairy legs.
Mm-hmm.
I trim it one time.
Yeah.
And right after that, I was like, oh no, this looks skinnier.
Yeah.
Because I guess the hair looks like add a little bit of body by the eye. I don't know.
Yeah.
So. Well, like, no, I don't like this.
And I would imagine just shaving your legs would be a lot of work.
There's people who do that. Like, for me, I'm...
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have a friend, he does waxing. I would be afraid to wax somebody.
Yeah.
He actually told me where he works, somebody burned one of the customers in their private part with the...
Oh my God, no, a lady?
The wax.
Mm-hmm. Wow. Yeah, that's risky. Ah.
people say you can't cup hair like body, over body hair. You can't. Everyone's body hair is different. You just have to keep applying the cup because sometimes the hair lets the air back into the cup. And when you feel that it's gravelly, that's where you have the adhesions. So you can feel like it was gravelly a few seconds ago and not smooth when I go there.
So about that. I never had like legs work like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's good though. You normally always focus on like upper. You get worse people than me?
Oh, making noises? Oh, yeah, definitely. I have one client. I'm going to have to tell him he's only allowed to come in on Sundays.
Because he screams?
Yeah. He's very loud. I told you the barber next door says he can hear people in here.
Oh, there's a barber here?
Not right now, but yeah.
Yeah, but like...
There's a lot of barbers here.
Oh.
And the one right next door, he saw me a few days ago, taking my client, and he says, oh, you know, I can hear you and they're hurting people. But it sounds like you like it.
Yeah, because it's like, you have like good pain.
This is, tends to be pretty painful. Deltoid in the pecs. It's fine, of course. I would just probably bleep it out.
Oh, man.
I work on one client. She calls me.
She what?
I work on one client. She calls me.
Oh, my God.
Pectoralis minor. So it's, you have a tiny chest muscle underneath the big one. And that's why you can feel the tissue just right in this little small area.
This is a good one. I don't want to remind you the bad one. Oh, Lord.
Trust me, I understand. I listen to myself all the time. It helps me with my elbow pain.
Damn.
Inside our ribs a little bit. And this should help if there's any inflammation.
Just ice?
Yeah, so it's a little gel ball with metal around it. Wow. You can get it on Amazon for like $25. You can also warm them up. Like, you can't put them in the microwave, but if you can like make hot water. And then drop the ball into it and then like heat it up.
It definitely feels like ice.
Mm-hmm. Right. But if I want to use heat, I'll use the hot stones. How's that feeling right now?
I'm good.
They never did it like this over there. Totally, I was like, and every time someone different, so I was like.
I always like experiments. I found that the ice can really help if someone's having a lot of pain. I was working the inner part of someone's thigh, and it was just so intense. But he needed it, and so I took the ice roller bottle.
What they do, like, you tell them what bothers you, right? And they put, like, the electro.
Gotcha.
Patch. Mm-hmm. And then someone will kind of give you, like, a small massage.
Mm-hmm.
And that's it.
But everyone's different, so you can't treat everyone the same.
Yeah, and they have it's called ultrasound, I guess.
Yeah.
It feels kind of like the cupping with the way you do it.
Yeah.
But that one, you feel like it moves everything.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I don't think I can do ultrasound. They can probably do it because they're working with a chiropractor.
Yeah.
And so they can do it under the chiropractor's license.
Yeah. But everyone uses it, not just the chiro. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I'm pretty sure you need a license. Here, very, very strict about that.
Well, if you're working for a chiropractor, I think it's like as long as they're in the building, you can do certain things.
Yeah. Like my mom is a nurse, right? Mm-hmm. So she knows a lot of stuff, but she can't work here because she's from Mexico.
Mm-hmm.
But she knows like everything, right? Mm-hmm. But here you need a license for everything.
Yes.
And I got a friend girl, she's esthetician, I guess, but she cannot use needles. Like, she cannot do Botox. And that has to be someone else. They got, like, another type of
Studies.
Yeah.
Every state you go to.
Yeah, everything's different.
Because I think in Florida, you can use needles. I think you can do that in Florida, but you have to go back to school for a separate certification on top of your license. Oh.
I can do, like, I know how to do, like, the syringes, like that. If you, let's say, you're sick or something, I can do because my mom teaches me.
Yeah. Like, in Florida, I wouldn't do
it. When you do esteroids, like, you know, so it's I learn. I asked her, like, how you learn? She told me, like, with orange. Mm-hmm. That's the way they teach. Yeah. Back in time over there, she was practicing in that orange.
In Florida, I can do, I forget what it's called, colon hydrotherapy, but basically you have to get a separate certification, but as a massage therapist we can do the thing where they put like a water hose thing up your butt and then they clean your insides. I don't understand why somebody wouldn't want that.
I was watching a video a long time ago or reading, I don't remember, but they say sometimes there's like feces that stay there for years.
And I know in India that they do that as a part of their medicine. They will use oils. So it's one of those weird things. I'm like, I don't know why that has to do with massage, but in Florida we can do it. And here in Texas I can actually give facials. I just can't use any strong chemicals.
Yeah.
But I can give a very basic facial. But if I wanted to use, like, you know, do a chemical pill, that would have to be an esthetician.
Oh, yeah, no, for that, yeah.
Or a hairdresser or a barber. Barbers can do everything in Texas. They just don't.
Like, my aunt, she cut hair, and she does all that, but she cannot do, like, the barber stuff.
Yeah.
That's a different license.
Yeah, she's a cosmetologist.
Yeah.
Yeah, if she had a barber's license, she could do everything. But is she here in Texas?
Yeah.
Yeah, so if she wants to, she can go back to school for 300 hours.
Yeah.
And there's an add-on she can get to her license.
Yeah.
And then I think the big difference for her is that she can't cut, she can't shave with a straight razor.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
And you have to go back to school for 300 hours for that.
That's crazy.
But if you're a barber in Texas, you can shave people, you can perm their hair, you can give them a facial, you can do their nails, you can do everything. Sex barbers can't do massage. They can massage your head, and they can massage right here, and they can massage your feet and ankles. And if you ever see some place where they say reflexology, and they try to do massage, that's they're not doing it properly. They didn't go to school. Texas reflexologists, they can't go past your ankles. But a lot of people don't know that they go there because they're really cheap.
But yeah. So like I used to be a bartender, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I used to have some customer, and he always like, hey, I got a massage store, or how do you call it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, business, when you going? But he was giving me like creeping by, so like every time he sees me, he's like, when you going? I'm not going to charge you.
Mm-hmm.
But it's massage. It's
mm-hmm.
I don't think he knows like what you know,
yeah.
what you can do.
Yeah.
So and then he gave me like the other vibe, said like I don't feel comfortable like
mm-hmm.
just him telling me.
Yeah.
I don't want to imagine what's there. Like I'm gonna be like, no, thank you.
Yeah. Well, you can always ask for their license number. Like by law we have to keep our license number on the premises. And then like, you can go to the website, the TDLR, and you can like look up their license and see if they're licensed. Because a lot of people who do reflexology, they're not massage therapists, and they can hurt you because they don't know what they're doing.
Yeah. Trust me, I went once in Las Vegas
mm-hmm.
to this place, and it was like... A lady, she did the massage.
Mm-hmm.
Can a little bit, some part where like I feel it, but
mm-hmm.
it wasn't good.
Yeah.
I was like, no.
How's that feel?
Yeah, very tight right think I should start working out since I get better.
Hmm. You can keep working, I don't know. You definitely don't want to stop moving, especially. So you may want to like cut, you know, back on the amount of weight. Mm-hmm. And do some more like, you know, like look up exercises to kind of strengthen your shoulder, you know, girdle. So like not just like the muscle, like the deltoid, and the biceps and stuff, but you may want to look up exercises for like the subscapularis and the infraspinatus. And lots of exercises
yeah,
that people do too.
Right.
Yeah, the lots of exercises that people do, like it's like just very gentle, like you know, very small movements that can, you know, just strengthen the muscles that hold your shoulders together. And sometimes you'll see people at the gym just doing these little exercises and they're just moving a little bit and just to strengthen those muscles.
And I don't even know how I did this. One day I started noticing, like, and the funny part, I have never had pain at all. Mm-hmm. So I guess when it happens, I didn't feel anything, so I was just like, keep doing it. But I hurt myself.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if you're exercising and you feel like it's getting worse, I would stop. But, you know, you don't have to stop exercising. They're just, you may need to find exercises that are good for this condition. Because sometimes, like, the tendonitis and the inflammation is caused by certain muscles being weak. And so you're having a big strain put on your body trying to do, you know, regular things.